Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about open sets and closed sets in matrix spaces. Let's get started. Let me begin by recalling an important notion, that is the definition of an open ball in a matrix space. Let C be an element of X and let R be a positive real number. The open ball with center C and radius R is the set BCR consisting of all X in X such that the distance between C and X is less than R. And please see the link in the description below for more information about open balls in matrix spaces. And people use open balls to define open sets in a matrix space. Let omega be a subset of a matrix space X. We say that omega is open if no matter what C in omega we take, there is some positive real number R greater than 0, such that the open ball with center C and radius R is a subset of the set omega. And a subset F of X is said to be closed if its complement is open. And this is the illustration of an open set in the Euclidean plane R2. This set is open because of the following reason. No matter what C you take in this set, there is R greater than 0, such that the open ball with center at C and radius R is a subset of the set omega. And we see that R usually depends on the center C. Okay, and in the next slides, I'm going to talk about some examples of open sets in different matrix spaces. The first one involves a subset of the matrix C01 with a max matrix. To know more about this matrix space, again, please see the link in the description below. Okay, so the set omega here is the set omega consists of all functions in C01 such that the function values are greater than 0 on this interval. Then we can show that omega is open in this matrix space. How can we do so? First of all, let's look at a typical element of the set omega. So this is the graph of the function f that belongs to omega. As you're going to see here, f of x is always greater than 0 for all x in the closed interval from 0 to 1. Next, we are going to use the definition of an open set in a matrix space to show that omega is open. Let's work on it. To prove that omega is open, we are going to use the definition by fixing any f in omega, and our goal is to show that there exists some radius R such that the open ball with center at f and radius R is a subset of the set omega. Okay, because f is in omega, f of x is strictly greater than 0 for all x in this interval. Then let R be the minimum value of f on this interval. R exists by the extreme value theorem. And again, by the extreme value theorem, R equals some f of x naught, where x naught is in this interval. Let's look at this figure. This is the graph of the function f, and this is x naught. This is the point at which the function f has an absolute minimum on the closed bounded interval 0, 1. Okay, and because f of x is greater than 0 for all x in this interval, f of x naught is also greater than 0, therefore R is greater than 0. Okay, so we see that R is greater than 0, and in our next step, we are going to show that the open ball with center f and radius R is a subset of omega. How can we do so? We're gonna take any element tree in this bond and show that it belongs to omega. Take any tree in this open bond. By the definition, the distance between F and G is strictly less than R, and recall that the max distance is given by this formula. This is DFG, okay? And from there, you're gonna see that the absolute value of F of X minus G of X is strictly less than R for all X in this interval. How come we have this? The reason is because the maximum value of the absolute value of f of x minus g of x for x runs in this interval is strictly less than 1. No matter what x you take in this interval, this absolute value is less than or equal to this maximum value, so it is strictly less than r. From there, you're going to see that f of x minus g of x is strictly greater than r and less than, f of x minus g of x is strictly greater than minus r and less than r for all x in this interval. Consequently, g of x is greater than f of x minus r for all x in this interval. And because what is r? R is the minimum function value of f on this interval. Therefore, no matter what input x you take, f of x is always greater than or equal to r, so this is greater than or equal to 0. Consequently, g of x is greater than 0 for all x in this interval. By the definition of the set omega, g belongs to omega. So we have seen that this open bond is a subset of omega. In summary, no matter what f you take in omega, there is some radius r greater than 0 such that this open bond is a subset of the set omega. Therefore, the set omega is open. Okay? Now, I'm going to talk about a different example. In this example, we consider an arbitrary non-empty set X with the discrete matrix on X given by this formula. Then it is very interesting that in X with this matrix, any set omega is both open and closed. Wow, it is very interesting that any subset of X is both open and closed. Let's go ahead and work on the proof. To show that omega is open, we're gonna use the definition again by taking any C in omega and show that there is some radius r greater than 0 such that the open bond with center at C and radius r is a subset of the set omega. In this situation, we're going to take r equals 1/2, which is a positive real number. Then the open bond with center at C and radius r is the open bond with center at C and radius 1/2, and it is just a single point set. How do we have this? Again, please look at the link in the description below to know how, to know why the open bond with center at C and radius 1/2 is C in this situation. And because C is in omega, this single point set is a subset of omega. To summarize, we take any C in omega and show that there exists some radius r greater than 0 such that the open bond with center at C and radius r is a subset of the set omega, therefore omega is open. Okay, now how to show that any subset of omega is closed? We have seen that any subset omega of X is open. Now, if we take an arbitrary set F in X, then its complement is still a subset of X. And we already proved that any subset of X is open. In particular, the complement of the set F is also open, and therefore F is closed. So we have seen that any subset of X is both open and close. Please think about it a little bit more. some people have confusion about the second part, but please think about it, because any subset omega of x is open, therefore any subset of x is closed. And finally, I'm going to talk about the matric topology. Let x be a matric space, and we denote by tau d the collection of all open sets in this matric space. Okay, so we have defined an open set in this matric space, and tau d consists of all such sets. Then we can show that tau d is a topology, and it is called the matric topology on X. So how to show that tau d is a topology? We're gonna show that it contains the empty set, that means the empty set is open. It contains X, that means the entire space X is open. We also need to show that it's closed under arbitrary union, and it is also closed under finite intersection, or just the intersection of two sets, okay? So on X, we can define different topologies, such as the indiscrete topology, the discrete topology, or the finite complement topology. However, whenever we say that tree is open in the matrix space X, we mean that tree is an element of the matrix topology. And what does it mean? Again, it means that no matter what C you take in the set tree, there is some radius R greater than 0 such that the open ball with center C and radius R is a subset of the set tree. This completes my video on open sets and closed sets in matrix spaces. If you like the video, please hit like, okay? And please consider subscribing to my channel to see more videos. Thank you for watching.